Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Charles. I want to welcome you guys to another episode of the Dreamers Pro Show, where we cover everything from sports, hot topics, classic debates, entertainment, and where we give you guys a fresh perspective on things and how we see them. And today, I have another interesting episode for you guys that you definitely want to stick around for, so make sure you go ahead and like the video and subscribe to the channel. So I was recently doing some research this morning, as we always do, when we're trying to come up with things to talk about. And I stumbled upon an article from SportsRush.com, an incredible article actually from SportsRush.com this morning that I want to get into. And as y'all know, Giannis Antetokounmpo is one of my favorite players in the NBA, even though my favorite player is actually Kawhi Leonard. But as y'all know, unfortunately, the Clippers did not make it into the playoffs because they lost Paul George and Kawhi didn't play. And I'm like, man, who am I going to root for apart from Giannis, right? So Giannis is the last guy I'm really rooting for in these NBA playoffs, but, you know, and I'm just trying to enjoy the games, right? So even though he's, you know, Kawhi is not there, you know, I still like Giannis a lot. And actually, I would be perfectly fine watching Giannis Antetokounmpo go back-to-back this year. I would be totally fine with it. A dude that some people say is not skilled and this and that and that. It would be lovely to see Giannis Antetokounmpo win an NBA championship. And I think a lot of people out there would like that. I think a lot of people outside the media love Giannis Antetokounmpo. There are a lot of fans globally, all over the world, that really love Giannis and really love what he represents, because the guy is just a hard worker. I mean, his career trajectory proves that. He's not about the fluff. If you look at Giannis, he seems to be a very, very simple guy that just goes out there and does the work, and he's dedicated to his craft. I think Giannis is playing basketball for the right reasons. The guy came into the NBA and he said to himself, listen, I have a once in a lifetime opportunity here. Literally a once in a lifetime. There are only 450 jobs, maybe 400 jobs in the NBA. How many jobs are there, right? So once in a lifetime opportunity. What's the chances you're going to be seven? I mean, like, really? And he said to himself, listen, I'm going to come into this league. I have a once in a lifetime opportunity. I'm going to make my mark and I'm going to make the most out of it. I understand that I'm here to accomplish goals, not to just, you know, twerk it up and look good and, you know, and floss and all that. I don't think that's what Giannis is about. He does do his thing in the offseason, but usually that's the offseason you can do your thing. But during the regular season, I think this guy's playing for the right reasons, right? And I think a lot of people love that about him, including me. I really do like that about him. So as y'all know, Giannis recently passed Kareem Abdul-Jabbar on the all-time Milwaukee Bucks scoring list. I think it was on April 21st of this year in 2022. It all depends. Somebody may see this video a year from now and say, really, what year was it? So it was in 2022. And today I stumbled upon an article actually from Sports Rush that really surprised me. And I want to get into a little bit of it. It starts off basically saying Giannis Antetokounmpo was just 11 points behind Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. It continues on, by saying, given that Giannis has been a walking double-double forever, the Greek Freak is all but guaranteed to overtake Lual Cinder on the all-time playoff scoring list for the Milwaukee Bucks. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, as Lou, it won't be called for over 50 years now, sits at 1,692 points for the Bucks. Giannis is only 10 behind him at the moment with 1,685 points in just 65 post-game appearances. And basically, the article goes on to really talk about it. So basically, Giannis is basically 10, 11 points away from being the all-time scoring leader in the playoffs for that organization. Let me tell you something. That's pretty impressive. That is pretty impressive, and I'll tell you why. For a guy that came into the NBA, think about this, in his first season, Giannis was averaging 6.8 points. He was shooting 41.4% from the field, 34% from the three-point line, 68% from the free throw line. He was getting you 4.4 rebounds, 1.1 assists per game, and 0.08 blocks per game, is now the guy that is about to pass Kareem Abdul-Jabbar on the all-time playoff scoring list for the Milwaukee Bucks. If that is not something, if that is not a story, I don't know what is. Who do you know comes into the NBA, their first year, they're averaging less than 7 points per game, and 8 years later, this guy is about to pass Kareem Abdul-Jabbar for the Bucks' all-time playoff scoring leader. It is incredible when you think about just the improvement and growth in this guy's career. As we speak, Giannis has scored 21 points in his NBA career. He's only played 9 years so far. The first year, as I just said, he averaged less than 7 points per game. Giannis, for the last 5 years, has averaged at least 27 points per game. In the last 5 years, not even the last, in the last in the last 6 years, Giannis has averaged a double-double. He's averaged at least 10 rebounds. He averaged 10, 12.5, 13.6 in 2019-2020 season, 11. And this season, he's averaging 11.5 rebounds per season. This season alone, he's shooting 72% from the free throw line. And he's averaged over the last, 4 years, at least 5 assists per game. He's averaged at least, think about this, over the last, let's say, 6 years, he's averaged at least 1 steal and at least 1 block per game. Giannis does every single thing on the court. The guy does everything. You saw him in the NBA Finals just last season. That's why I got upset when Stephen A. Smith, J.J. Redick said the guy put up a 50-piece, and he said, so? What do you mean, so? What do you mean by so? How many people have you seen gone out there in an elimination games in an NBA Finals deliver a performance like that, and at the end of it, you say, so? How many people have you seen do that? Did y'all see that play when I think Chris Paul, or maybe it was Devin Booker, running the pick and roll for Andre Ayton, and he tried to roll to the basket. He was able to show hard on the pick and roll and then recover and block the lot. How many guys in the NBA can perform that type of play? That play is the essence of what Giannis Antetokounmpo is. The guy can do literally everything. And if he keeps scoring like this and keeps improving like this, and he keeps playing at this level, let's say for the next, 8 to 9 years, Giannis could most likely end up in the top 5 in NBA scoring history, in NBA history. He can definitely make it into the top 5. That's for sure. And I've said, Giannis Antetokounmpo is one of the few, the very few players playing today that has a legitimate, I'm talking about a legitimate chance to make it into the top 5 or at least the top 10 greatest players of all time. He is one of the few people that has the opportunity to do that. One of the very few that can do that. And I think it's something that scares a lot of people out there. Maybe not some fans, but some other people. They get bothered by this because he's a foreign guy. And I said this the other day, and I think I said it. I said 10 of the top, 4 of the top 10 players in the NBA right now are foreign guys. If you just look at the MVP, it's most likely going to be Nikola Jokic. The last guy that just won the finalists are all foreign guys. And I told you, this game is evolving. And I said for American players, because I'm born in the States, they see this coming. You need to see where the trend is going to really sit up. Giannis Antetokounmpo is showing you that the thing that you guys, some of you guys don't take seriously, the opportunity that some of you guys are not willing to seize, he will seize it. There's no good reason that Giannis is just simply outworking the majority of the NBA. That's really what this guy is doing. He is literally outworking everyone. Because if you look at his game, Giannis didn't have a refined basketball game. He just didn't. What he did was work on his craft. And look where it's got him. He doesn't talk any trash. You don't see him posting anything on Twitter. He just does his job. And look where it's got him. So to me, I think it's astonishing that this guy is about to pass Kareem on the Bucks all-time scoring list. And he was a guy that averaged less than 7 points his first year in the NBA. That is remarkable. So what I want to know from you guys, what do you think about this? Whatever you guys think, please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section. And we'll definitely catch you guys on the next episode. Peace.